Good evening, friends and neighbors. Welcome. My name is Erin Gray, and I'm the artistic director and conductor of the San Diego Saints Choir. We are so grateful to be here and so grateful that you are here. We're grateful to be able to sing again, and especially at this very important time of year and on this Palm Sunday, getting ready for very sacred Easter. I wanted to also express our gratitude to the many that have assisted behind the scenes, including our lighting crew and sound and recording engineers, communication specialists, and those who decorated. Thank you, thank you. Now I invite you to sit back and take a moment to let go of any worries that you may have. Enjoy the spirit that comes from listening to sacred music, especially music about the Savior Jesus Christ.
On the Sunday before Passover, as Jesus came nigh unto Jerusalem for the feast, he sent two of his disciples, saying, "Go ye into the village over against you, in the which ye shall find a colt tied. Loose him and bring him hither." And they brought the colt to Jesus, and they cast their garments upon him, and they set Jesus thereon. And a very great multitude spread their garments in the way. Others cut down branches from the trees and strawed them in the way. And when he was come nigh, even now at the descent of the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of the disciples began to rejoice and praise with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen.
Of ages and prophets foretold, for whom we have waited ere long, have come to redeem us from slavery's yoke and deliver his people back home. Come, Israel, come see the one who shall reign.
Oh,
On the final evening of his mortal ministry, after the Last Supper was concluded, Jesus promised peace to his disciples. In this next song, you will hear these words of peace. You will also hear the word shalom, which was used both as a greeting and as a farewell, and it continues in use today. It means wholeness, welfare, a state of fullness, complete reconciliation with God. May you hear and feel the Savior extending this all-encompassing peace to you.
Thank you. Watch my eyes and bid them see that my gaze might pierce the veil and behold the wondrous scene that in dreams I've long beheld. Oh, touch my heart and bid it know that every sorrow here is but a moment's tear, and thou wilt make me my ears and bid them hear all the glories of thy truth, that my hope might come of faith and no more require proof. Oh, touch my heart and bid it know that while in darkness here, the light is ever near, and thou wilt make me whole again. Touch my lips and bid them sing songs of everlasting praise, that my soul might then believe and give thanks for all my days. Oh, touch my heart tender grace, and thou wilt make me whole, and thou wilt make me whole, and thou wilt make me whole again.
I cannot watch them take my Lord. I can't endure their cruel hands upon him. while his own hands are tied with cord. Those hands with power to raise the dead command the storm now bound instead, and I cannot hear them mock his name. I cannot bear the foul breath upon him. I dare not look upon his face and see the very Son of God, his brow so bruised and stained with blood, his eyes that shed my sorrow's tears, watch as all hope disappears. I will not watch them crucify my Lord. For I know this man, I know him. I know this man. I cannot watch what he must bear, for surely he must carry all my burden. Forgive me, Lord, that I'm not there. But when my eyes are closed in death, these words will hang on my last breath. I know.
The sorrow and uncertainty on that Friday must have been devastating to those that loved and believed in him. Elder Joseph B. Worthland said, "I think of how dark that Friday was when Christ was lifted up on the cross. Each of us will have our own Fridays, those broken times when it seems we can never be put together again. But Sunday will come. In the darkness of our sorrows, Sunday will come. No matter our desperation, no matter our grief, in this life or the next, Sunday will come. And on that Sunday, Jesus ascended from the grave and appeared gloriously triumphant as the Savior of all mankind, the proof that death is merely the beginning of a new and wondrous existence."
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. And grace will lead.
Glory, glory to the Lord. Glory, glory, Father, life
Have you ever felt like the disciples who walked with Jesus on the road to Emmaus but didn't recognize him? They felt their hearts burn as he talked with them by the way, and later they realized who he was. As you listen to these next pieces, you may be reminded of the times that the Holy Spirit has warmed your heart and helped you to recognize the Lord's presence in your life. May you also feel that witness of his promise that whosoever believeth in me, though he may die, yet shall he live.
Thank you. stand and cast a wishful eye to Canaan's fair and happy land where my possessions lie. There's generous fruits that never fail on trees immortal grow. There rocks and hills and brooks and bells with milk and honey flow. I am bound for the promised land. I'm bound for the promised land. Oh, who will come and go with me? I am bound for the promised land. I am bound for the promised land. I'm bound for the promised land. Oh, who will come and go with me? I am bound for the promised land.
Mountains, floating branches, sea land rises to my sight. Sweet dreams arrayed in living green and rivers of delight. Where shall I reach that happy place and be forever blessed? When shall I see my Father's face and in his bosom rest? I am bound for the promised land. I'm bound for the promised land.
And I will rise.
after appearing to many, he led the disciples out as far as Bethany, and he lifted up his hands, and he blessed them. And it came to pass that while he blessed them, he was parted from them and carried up into heaven. And they worshiped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy and were continually in the temple praising and blessing God. He died for all of us, and now he lives for all of us. His love for us is immeasurable. And because of that love, he promises, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. We testify that Jesus lives and that he has ascended into heaven. But if we will believe in him, he will always be with us.
Thank you.
It is our custom to close our concerts with a piece by Elaine Hagenberg titled Deep Peace. It is a Gaelic blessing we wish to leave with you, and it ends with the text, Deep Peace of Christ, the light of the world to you. Anyone who has sung this piece with us before is welcome to join us on the stand. And at the conclusion of Deep Peace, Randy Johnson will offer the benediction. We wish you the deepest peace of Christ in this glorious Easter season.